Hi, 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 hello friends. Welcome to my YouTube channel. We'll continue our discussion on SSC JEE 2012 Electrical Submissions Part 17. The question here is, magnetic blowout coils are generally used in oil circuit breaker, vacuum circuit breaker, and air brake circuit breaker, air latch circuit breaker. As you can see here, the magnetic blowout air brake circuit breaker. So the answer is here, air brake circuit breaker here. So what will happen here? So here we have two contacts, stationary contact, moving contact. Whenever the arc produced here, so what we will do is we'll insert some gases here so that the arc will be extinguished like this in a arc chance, and arc on is here, so that we can reduce the arcing arcing intensity, and so that we can increase the arcing length here. So they are used in air brake circuit breakers. Next question here is, the pitch factor for a full pitched winding of a synchronous machine is. So the pitch factor formula is Kp is equal to cos alpha by 2. So this is the pitch factor formula here. So what is the pitch factor here? So here the pitch angle is here. So this is the actual span of angle is here. We have north pole and south pole, which will make an angle of 180 degrees. This is electrical. So electrical degree here. So what we are doing in order to help with the harmonics, we are decreasing the length of this pitch of this coil by some angle called alpha here. This is what short pitch angle here. Okay. So for a full pitched winding means, so full pitched winding. Full pitched winding. So alpha is 0. So once alpha is 0, pitch factor Kp is equal to cos 0 by 2. So cos 0 means 1. So pitch factor is 1 for full pitched winding. So Kp is 1 here. Next question here on the screen is, an AC meter of resistance Rm and XM is connected in series with the resistance Rs here. A shunt impedance of RSH plus JXH is applied in parallel to the existing combination of meter and RS. The current division across the two branches will be independent of frequency when the time constant of this upper branch should be equal to the time constants of lower branch here. So what's the upper branch time constant? Tau is equal to L by R. So here they have given inductances. So T1 I will write here, L1, R1. So here XM divided by RM plus RS is a total resistance, and for lower branch you can write tau 2 is nothing but L2 divided by R2. So L2 is how much here? So XSH divided by RSH. So when these two are equal, at that time you can say the current is independent of frequency. So here XM divided by RM plus RS is equal to XSH divided by RSH. So this is the answer for this question. The answer is B. Next question. In phantom loading arrangement, energy consumption in the calibration test of wattmeter is reduced because of the absence of load in the test, separation application of low voltage supply across the current coil, no common point between two coils, the reduced losses in current coil and pressure coil. As you can see here, when we are doing calibration of single phase energy meter here, so here there is no direct load is connected here. So no load is connected to the energy meter, so that the options of the answer is the energy consumption is less because there is no load. So absence of load in the test set here. That's the answer. Next question here is, in the measurement of power in a balanced three-phase circuit between two watt meter method, if the two watt meters shows equal reading, then the power factor of the circuit is. So this type of problems we have discussed in our previous SSC JEE solutions. So we'll go through it again. So W1 is the reading, which is say root 3 into V1 phase into I phase into cos 30 minus phi, and a W2 will be root 3 into V phase into I phase into cos 30 plus phi. So here W1 is proportional to cos 30 minus phi, W2 is proportional to cos 30 plus phi. So when these two are equal, so W1 is equal to W2 means, so cos 30 minus phi is equal to cos 30 plus phi. So when these two should be equal means phi should be 0. So when phi should be 0, what about power factor cos phi? Is nothing but cos 0 is nothing but 1. So that is unity power factor. So thank you friends, thanks for watching my videos. Have a nice day.